Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 3.3, Problem 7. This is Section 3.3, Problem Number 7. It says the following is a list of the ages of all U.S. presidents at the time of their inauguration. Find the five-number summary, find the interquartile range, draw the box plot. So for the five-number summary, we have to find the smallest theta value, Q1, Q2, Q3, and the largest theta value. Now, fortunately, this list is already in order, which saves us a good amount of work. Putting a list this big in order would be the most work of the whole problem. So since it's in order, I can see that the smallest theta value is 42. That'd be the youngest president when they were inaugurated, and 69, the oldest president when they were inaugurated. So 42 is the smallest, 69 is the largest. Now for the quartiles, you have to find the second quartile first. That's the median or midpoint of the list. There are 45 values in this list. So you can count them up, but we have five rows of nine. There really are 45. So fortunately, 45 is an odd number. So an odd amount of data will have one data value right in the center. So for 45, if you think about it, you should have 22 data values. The 23rd position will be the median, and then 22 more data values. So that adds up to 45, and the 23rd position is the middle position. 22 that are smaller, 22 that are bigger. So since these are rows of 9, this is position 9, position 18, and as I start the next row, position 19, position 20, position 21, position 22, position 23. This president, who was 55 when they were inaugurated, is right in the center of the list. And geometrically, the way the list is written, you can even kind of see it's in the center. So there's 22 presidents that were younger at the time of their inauguration, 22 that were older. 55 is the midpoint, which makes it Q2. It's the median. Now that I have Q2, I can go back and find Q1. Q1 is the median of the smaller half of the data, not including Q2. So the smaller half of the data, not including Q2, are the 22 presidents that were younger than 55 years old when they were inaugurated. So 22 now is an even amount of data. So for an even amount of data, the median occurs between the two middle values. So there's going to be 11 positions smaller than that midway point, and 11 positions that are bigger. The midpoint will be in the space in between those. In the space in between position 11 and the next one would be position 12. So 11 on each side, but in between position 11 and position 12. Now, again, we're in rows of 9, so the last entry of the top row is in position 9. This will be position 10. Position 11. So right in between position 11 and position 12, between 50 and 51, will be Q1. Now you can do the math, but I can see between 50 and 51 must be 50.5. So that will be Q1. 50.5, or you can call it 50 and one half if you like. Now it's going to be the same type of process to find Q3. Q3 will be the median of the upper half of the data, not including Q2. So the upper half of the data, not including Q2, will be the 22 presidents that were older than that middle president at the time of their inauguration. Now you do have a double value, even quadruple value of 55, but it's really by position. It doesn't matter that this is the same. When I say not including Q2, it's not including the value in that position, even though coincidentally that's a match. I'm not going to eliminate all those 55s. Just the single 55 that's right in the center. So I have 22 values bigger than the center value, so it's going to split up the same way, 11 smaller, 11 bigger. So if I count out from this starting point of the upper half, count out 11, I'll find what's in between that position 11 and position 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I want what's between position 11 and position 12, between 58 and 60. Well, again, I can see it must be 59. I mean, you can do the math, but 59 is clearly the midpoint between 58 and 60. So there's my five number summary. Big list of data, but because the data was in order, made it not too bad. Now, next, the interquartile range. The interquartile range is Q3 minus Q1. So for this data, Q3 is 59 minus Q1 is 50.5. So if you subtract 59 minus 50.5, it will be 18.5. That's my interquartile range. And finally, part C, draw the box plot. Again, the box plot is going to look like you're going to have a number scale going up the side, and you're going to have a picture with a box. There's a line in the box, a line coming out of the bottom and top. And again, this can be drawn left to right. I draw them more side to side, up and down rather. The bottom edge of the box is Q1. The line in the box is Q2. The top edge of the box is Q3. The line coming out of the top goes to your largest data value. The line coming out of the bottom goes to the smallest. Now, my biggest data value is 69. I don't want to draw 69 lines. I could. Going by tens would be better. You could do fives. By fives, it takes 14 lines to get up to 70, because some of these are grouped pretty close. You also have the option of not necessarily starting at zero, which you could do. Since the youngest president was 42, you could start at 40. That'd be okay. Or you could start at zero and make an appropriate scale. I think I'll start at zero and go by fives. So I need 14, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. In general, I like to keep my number scale to about 10 lines. 14 is close enough, within reason. So I'll label it up, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, 55, 60, 65, 70 should accommodate all my data. And you can even put in a couple more if you like. You don't have to. And again, I could have started at 40 and picked a different number scale. That'd be okay too, as long as you label it. So, now, in terms of drawing the box, I like to draw the bottom edge and top edge first. And you don't have to do it that way, but that's how I do it. Q1 is the bottom edge of the box. For this particular problem, Q1 is 50.5. Now, I don't have 50.5 on my number scale, but 50 is so close, and I'll go just the tiniest bit higher for 50.5. The top edge of the box is Q3. Which will be at a height of 59. I don't have 59 exactly on my number scale. I have a 60, which is close. So I'm going to come down a little less than the 60 for 59. Connect up the box. There's a line inside the box at a height of Q2. My Q2 for this problem is 55. I do happen to have a line exactly at 55, so I'll put my line right at that height. Now I'm going to have a line coming out of the bottom of the box going to the smallest data value. Our smallest data value for this problem is 42. That would have been Teddy Roosevelt. So 42, I don't have 42 exactly on my number scale. So 42.5 would be right between the 40 and the 45. So 42, tiny bit lower than the halfway point. About like that. The oldest president, 69. I don't have 69, so figure 70 and go a little bit lower. And that would be the box plot.